Hello, I'm Mr. R. Nijjar, a retired lecturer in metallurgy preaching Christianity and Sikhism. Here I'm describing the five husbands of the Samaritan woman in the book revision, and this is video number 4. So Jesus declared, "Believe me, woman, a time, dark age of spirit," this is the dark age of spirit, "is coming when you will worship the Father," our God, you know, our spiritual father, "and no more the dead tribal fathers called Illa, neither on this mountain nor in Jerusalem." That is the time of the temples made by human hands of brick and cement has gone, and now you worship in your own temple of God in spirit, led by your own Christ in the heart. So you don't need to have these dog-collar priests. They are crook, you know, and only they're turning stones into bread. You Samaritans worship what you do not know. Now this is a corruption by the Messianic Jews. Messianic Jews speaking in terms of the letters and not spirit, you know. We worship what we do know, by the letters, dead letters. This is a corruption by the Messianic Jews to bring forward their rotten Torah full of holes, for salvation is from the Jews, seems to have been added on by the Satanic people. How could the spiritually sick Jews cure this already healthy Samaritans who are living in the royal kingdom of God? They are already living there, and these are living in hell, you know, these Jews, which Jesus took them out and took them to the royal kingdom of God, where the Samaritans were already present. That is why Samaritans did not need Christ Jesus. Yet a time is coming, has now come, when the true worshippers will worship the living Father in spirit, and not by the dead letters of the Bible, as they do today, and truth. So you worship in spirit and in truth, not in the dead letters and the works, you know, that comes from the core of your heart. Truth comes from the core of your heart, not hypocrisy. For they are the kind of worshippers the living Father seeks. Our Father God seeks such worshippers who worship in truth and in spirit, not by the letters of the books. God is spirit, abstract, and his worshippers must worship in Holy Spirit and in gospel truth. The woman said, "I know that Messiah is coming." This declaration of the Samaritan woman reflects how deep was her understanding of the religious knowledge by Holy Spirit, common sense, that she and her people possessed. When he comes, he will explain everything to us. What a beautiful statement the woman made that reflected her deep religious knowledge. And indirectly, we can say that she was a highly religious person who was gifted with Holy Spirit that could read the signs of age. She knew what Christ stands for. Then Jesus declared, "I who speak to you am he." That is, Christ Jesus was so pleased with her deep religious knowledge in spirit as to give out his own identity with great pleasure, which he hid from the helots and the psychic Jewish Jerusalem psychics. Just then his laborers returned, and they were surprised to find him talking with a woman. Normally, you know, with a woman talking is a They normally talk with many, you know, rabbis. But here he was talking with the woman. Women are supposed to know less than the men. That means, but this woman was more knowing, not less than the men. In Jesus, or in spirit, we are neither male or female in flesh. It is our soul that count. So women and men are same. But no one asked, what do you want? Or why are you talking with her? Because Jesus was their brother, brother. So they were not treating Jesus like a master or anything, or any superior, They were treating him like their own brother, like little children. So they would not dare to ask him, why you are talking to them. Because otherwise they would have asked him, such question. And that is, Jesus and the Samaritan woman were locked in such a serious, deep philosophical discussion that even his laborers dare not interrupt it. So they did not want to interrupt them, Then leaving her water jar for Jesus and his laborers to enjoy, the woman went back to the town and said to her people, come, see a man who told me everything that I knew and not ever did, That is, these messianic Jews, they wanted to make this story bad. They turned it into that she was a sinner and all that. All nonsense. Corruption. So this woman told them whatever she knew, he told me, he understood, he knows more than me. And not even, that is all her religious achievements that Christ Jesus has come to know. Could this be the Christ? That means the nomadic solitaries. They all village people were solitaries, They were all nomadic. Do not impose their own findings upon the others, but let them find it out by themselves through spirit, by vetting the person through spirit, as gospel is by grace on individual basis. This is emphasized in the practice at Eucharist, that you cannot pour Eucharist wine from one cup person to other. Now, I attended one of the Catholic annual meeting. Over there, they were giving lecture. One man gave a lecture, Catholic father, they call him, that you can't pour Eucharist wine from one cup into the other. I was dozing, all of a sudden when he said I woke up. And then afterward, I asked them, why can't you pour it, They say, this is a precious blood. In case you spill it, none of them knew why they can't pour it. And I went to Oxford University. Over there were Catholic fathers again meeting. And I asked the same question, why can't you pour wine from one cup into the other? They say, it's not only the wine, we mix it with water also. So we mix wine with water. I said, then tell me, Christ, Jesus never mixed wine with water. Why do you do it? Oh, they start asking each other, did Christ Jesus mix water with wine? So they don't know, why they mix water. Water is Old Testament and wine is the New Testament. This binding of the old cloth with the brand new cloth is to justify that they are putting water into the wine, which is wrong, because the spirit is free of the moral laws. Water stands for moral laws. And you can't, mix the moral laws plus spirit. Spirit sets you free, moral laws, they bind you. You can't do the both thing, So it is wrong to mix water, or you can't pour Eucharist wine from one cup to the other. because the gospel is received by the grace of our Father, and not any person can give. Christ Jesus could not give gospel to Peter. That is why he was called stone, that he was with the fountain of gospel, but he could not absorb any, because it was not written in him. He was not predestined to receive gospel. But he had another part to be played, which is common in churches. There are people who are like Peter, who are honest and they don't tell lie. So that is the part he has to play. To key to the kingdom of heaven was given to Peter for telling the truth, speaking the truth, not telling lies. They came out of the town and made their way towards him. This gesture of welcoming Jesus amply reflects that the people of this town were very sensible people, and they did not wait for Christ Jesus, the fountain of living water, to go to them, but rather they went out towards him to greet him and to welcome him into their humble village. In other towns, people did not come out to greet Jesus. If they did so, it was mostly to get their sick people healed. Whilst the people of Sychar did not come out to greet Jesus for the sick, but to honor a highly knowledgeable person, the anointed royal high priest of God, a prophet of this dark age, in the name of Jesus. Meanwhile, his laborers urged him, "Rabbi, eat something." But he said to them, "I have spiritual food to eat that you know nothing about." Then his laborers said to each other, "Could somebody have brought him food?" "My food," said Jesus, "is to do the will of him who sent me and to finish his work. Do you not say 4 months more and the harvest?" 4 months mean 4 ages. Fourth age, this is the dark age, and this is the age of harvest, age of sun. Previously, these were the ages of moon. The Rabbi, "I tell you, open your spiritual third eyes and look at the fields, hearts of people, for they are white, ready to harvest." The last words, "for they are white, are ready to harvest," beautifully reflect the character and religious achievements of the people of Sychar. Now the physical crop, when they are ready for harvesting, take on a golden yellow color. Therefore, the crop Jesus is talking about here is not the physical one, but the spiritual human crop of hearts, of the people's hearts. And the white color signifies that the people of Sychar were religiously pure and clean at heart, like those of the little children, and not the dirty-hearted hypocrites and sinners like those of Jerusalem, the Jews, you know. To my best knowledge of the New Testament, Jesus never spoke so well of people as that of these in the whole of his missionary work. Even now the reapers are the Christ, you know. Jesus, the master fisherman, draws his wages. Wages mean of salvaging the people. You know, we are fishers of men. When we fish a person, that is our wage. That is our, we take it up, that is our treasure, you know. And that is our wage. And more we make the people solitary, the greater are our wages. Remember how Simeon greeted child Jesus in the temple. When Christ Jesus was taken to temple in the first week, you know, how Simeon greeted him. I have seen my salvation. And let your servant go. He summarized what Christ Jesus came for. Even now, the harvest and the crop for eternal life, so that the sower, the village rabbi that prepared the people like Samaritan woman spiritually, and the reaper, Christ Jesus, who set them in the field as apostles, may be glad together. So the village rabbi is happy to see that Christ has reaped the crop which he has sown. Remember that John the Baptist, the best man of the marriage of 11 virgins at the Eucharist, also was happy to see the virgin brides getting themselves married, getting themselves to be married to bridegroom Christ Jesus at the Eucharist ceremony, when Christ Jesus welcomed the 11 brides into the house of our Father by washing their feet, a custom in the Middle East stressed by Christ Jesus, when the proud Pharisee Simon did not greet Jesus by washing his feet, but Mary Magdalene, a sinner in the eye of Pharisee, did wash them with her tears of extreme love for Jesus and dried them with her honor, the head hair. Thus the saying, one that rabbi priest of Moses sow, another royal priest of our Father God reaps for salvation, is true. This crop is the spiritual one of the people, in which the people prepared by their rabbis are to be harvested by the royal roving preachers, the fishers of men in the name of Christ Jesus, because that is the son they have been married to. Whilst in the normal physical crop, the sower and the reaper is the same person. You sow and you reap it, you know. Nobody else come and reap your crop, otherwise it is called stealing. So 70 outer circle laborers, priests, they were priests in Moses, were prepared in the name of John the Baptist to act as the best men or to prepare the crop for harvesting by the royal roving priest, the apostles. Also, Jesus the reaper cannot enter into your heart of his own will, but you have to invite him in. I sent you to reap what you have not worked for. Here Christ Jesus, our anointed royal high priest, says that he is sending his laborers, the apostles, to reap the crop that the rabbis had prepared through their hard works, making them suitable for the grace of our Father to understand gospel and be harvested by the royal priests. Others, the moral teachers, rabbis, have done the hard work, and you have reaped the benefits of their labor, as Christ Jesus harvested a heavy crop in this Samaritan village. Thus said Christ Jesus, Thomas in Logo 22:16, let there be among you a man of understanding in pneumatic. When the fruit ripened, people becomes white-hearted. He came quickly with his sickle of gospel, the double-edged sword, in his hand, and he reaped it. This and the next parable, Matthew 19, are the most difficult parables to understand, and they are best learned through a lively heart-to-heart discussion I can give this discussion in greater details, but there are no customers. Our Father God blesses you and hope you enjoy the videos. Oh dear.